In this tutorial, I'm going to go through the process of cutting a decal template using StoneCut or StoneCut Pro. So we have our completed template. All the trimming and welding has been done, so it's all ready to cut. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to transfer the image over to StoneCut. Now, if everything is selected, everything that's selected will transfer over. If nothing's selected, everything will transfer over. But if one object is selected, only that object will transfer over. So what I want to do is just deselect everything to transfer this over to StoneCut. You'll notice I have a toolbar. This toolbar was installed when the StoneCut software was installed. You'll notice there's a little icon here that says cut. What I want to do is click on the cut icon, and I want to transfer this image over to StoneCut. Works exactly the same way in StoneCut Pro. So the image is transferred over, and you'll notice when it comes over, it's grouped. What I want to do is select it and go to Design and click on Break Group, or I can also click on Control B on my keyboard to break the group. Now the reason I want to break the group is I want to optimize the material, and in order to do that I have to group each individual decal layout. So what I'm going to do is grab my pick tool, I'm going to marquee select around the decal, I'm going to hit Control G to group it, I'm going to do the same thing for each one. Control G, marquee select, Control G, marquee select, Control G. So these are all individually grouped objects. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on my little icon for the cutter, and that's going to open the output to device window. I want to make sure my cutter is selected in the drop-down list. If I've already set up a material profile for vinyl, I want to make sure that's selected. And you'll notice under my pressure I have 80, and under speed I have 108 centimeters per second. So that's maximum speed on this Jaguar 4 cutter. There's really no reason to slow the cutter down for cutting decal vinyl. You'll also notice I have the option for weed border checked. I've put a setting of 0.2 in here. I have sort before output checked. And if we made any changes to that, I could just click on Save Settings. Now, if I have a cutter connected, in many cases, I can read material to get the material width, and then that would read out my material width. So I'm going to just enter 22.5, which would be about right for 24-inch vinyl. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut all objects. So I'm not going to cut by selected color. I'm going to cut all of the objects. So I'm just going to go over here and click on Preview. And there's our preview. Now this is a pretty bad usage of material, and so what we want to do is optimize the material. And the easiest way to do that is just to select the objects, go over to Options, and click on Optimization. You notice I put a weed border between each object, so I put a value of 0.2 in here. I've also checked Rotate as needed. I'm going to click on OK. There's my image. Now I don't need to mirror the image. When you're cutting regular vinyl, it's cutting right facing, so there's no requirement to mirror the image. And you'll also notice if you zoom in here that this particular image, it's actually two color. There's white where the central baseball is, and then the red. So as long as we're cutting all objects, we can just weed out that white part, and that'll work out perfectly. So, and when we're ready to cut, all we need to do is to simply click on the output function to send this to the cutter. And that concludes this tutorial lesson.